Hello, everybody. My name is Sinvicta, and welcome back to Darkest Dungeon Season 4. We are ready to go for a very special challenge, the final challenge for this week. This one was submitted by Giuseppe Luna. Hopefully, I said that name correctly. I probably didn't, but if I didn't, then just let me know in the comments down below. And it is the most valuable payer challenge. And basically, what this is it is going to be an Antiquarian-Off between Maggie and Daisy. Now, really quickly before we go into this run, first off, I have advanced the save file by about 3 weeks because we had Maggie. She was our antiquarian. We were just waiting to get the second one. I did finally get a second antiquarian just now, so that's the reason why I'm doing this. But just so you all know, there has been a couple weeks that have been progressed in the story, or not in the story, but in the campaign, because we were just waiting for an antiquarian. I didn't want to do any sort of loading in with like a mod that adjusts the stagecoach size or anything like that. I just did a couple of blood runs, and that was about it. So here we go. On our team today, it's going to be little Daisy. She's going to be in the first position here. I gave her the Carapace Idol along with Wilbur's flag. Obviously, we have to keep everyone alive, and I'll go over the challenge once we get in there. Then we also have Maggie. So it's going to be Maggie versus Daisy. It's going to be a puppy versus Margaret Crone. And then Jesse, of course, we're bringing him for security and damage. Same thing goes for Tenchi. They're just going to be here and killing stuff. So again, the idea is very similar to the Mathis versus Tanny challenge, except this time around, there's no damage involved. It's all about who can bring home the most gold in the dungeon. Is it going to be my almost 1-year-old puppy, or is it going to be Maggie? We'll see. So, and again, thank you to Giuseppe Luna, and I will go into the dungeon right now. By the way, I'm also doing this dungeon as a dark run, and I had to do this one. I was going to wait to get them on the even levels, because I don't know if that affects the amount of gold that they can get. I'm pretty sure it doesn't, but we have a chance to get the Profane Scroll, which is one of my favorite, absolute favorite trinkets in the entire game for the Vestals. So that's why I was like, no, we got to do this now. So here we go. And again, thank you to Giuseppe Luna. Again, apologies if I'm mispronouncing that first name incorrectly. I mean no offense by it. Yeah, we're not going to need too many of that. We will need some keys, though. So, and this actually works out quite well because we're also, like, really needing gold. So now is a good time for a long dark run. And let's get her done. The most valuable payer. Who will it be? Place your bets now between Daisy and Maggie. Here we go. So this challenge was very simply bring two antiquarians into any dungeon. The values of gold for every item that have been accumulated through the dungeon by interacting with curios will be tallied up. We're going to keep a running tally. Otherwise, I'm not going to be able to keep track of who got what. I will be counting the gold value for like torches, holy water, anything that the antiquarians loot. I'm going to tally that and give it its own financial value, which the game defines. You can just look at your inventory. There are a couple restrictions. First off, both must take turns interacting with curios, and they must interact with every encountered curio. So even the ones that don't have loot in it, which I'm not really a huge fan of, because I know that there's some that just flat out just don't give loot. But hey, I'm not the one who made the challenge. So I'm assuming that that Giuseppe that's what they were going for. Whichever antiquarian has the most gold wins. So here we go. It's the great antiquarian off. Let's rock and roll.
Pace out the halls of your lineage once familiar. Now, foreign.
All right. So we have to explore 90% of the rooms. This is a long run, by the way. And we're just going to start right off with dark.
The darkness holds much worse than mere trickery.
And let's see how good or bad this goes. That's why I brought the higher levels here to help out in case we do encounter anything nasty. So, and I have flipped a coin. It is going to be Daisy who is taking the first loot.
Another abomination cleansed.
Because there was nothing defined in the challenge that said who got the loot first. One off lethal, count it. Ah, Tenchi, I forgot to give you your judgment. So the maggot's gonna get a chance to go, and they're gonna go straight for Maggie. Which is about the only target we can't have them hit. Maggie has 17 HP. There we go.
Give them no.
Now, I'm not going to be counting the gold that we get after fights. Literally, the only gold I'm going to be talking about is the ones that the antiquarians physically get from curios. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. So, again, I did a coin flip. Daisy will be the first one looting. All right. Well, there you go. That was her loot. And remember, I have to interact with every curio, and I have to flip-flop between the two. I'm gonna go after Jesse and Kenchi, and I'm honestly fine with that. Yeah, there we go. Jesse with a big smack.
Destroy them all.
Maggie swinging a whiff. Now, I thought about bringing the new antiquarian cloak that we had found the other day, but I decided not to because I want to. It actually had minus dodge, and I don't want minus dodge.
Another one falls.
Big ol' 4 damage there. I'm gonna have Jesse guard Maggie just in case. Now, whenever you use Protect Me, it does give the person who is the Protectee a whole lot of dodge. Which, of course, failed right there, but had it not, I would have looked really smart at the time. And I'm super excited to get the Profane Scroll. Like, that has me giddy. Yeah, I'll get a heal here. And we might as well start using the Festering Vapors. That's a nice thing about bringing the Antiquarian into the ruins is that they do have blight damage they can deal.
Their
there we
formation
go.
Is broken. Maintain the offensive.
So is this one going to be as exciting as Tanny versus Mathis? I don't know, maybe. You never know where you can derive competition from. Well, Maggie's first curio is going to be a bookshelf. And she got a negative quirk, a weak grip on life. That is the worst. All right, well, congrats on that, Maggie. Daisy finally gets something. That's going to be 500. So Daisy starts off with 1,250 gold. Of course, we're not counting the curios, or not the curios, but the heirlooms. So 1,250 gold provided by a little puppy Daisy. Daisy takes the lead. The first lead of the day. I don't know who's cheering for who here. Alright, well, Maggie gets another bookshelf, so an old journal entry. Hey, you can actually get stuff. Wow, I didn't know that. Who knew that you could get heirlooms and gold out of bookshelves? So Maggie brings home 550 gold. I'm surprised by that. Good job, Maggie. I did not know you could get gold out of those. I have learned something today. Alright, let's go for... Let's get the Cordier out of here first.
The ground quakes.
Now is also the time that I can say, hey, look, Antiquarians deal damage. They do deal good damage, I'm telling you. I'm going to convince people one day that Antiquarians deal good damage. Respectable damage, one-off lethal, count it.
The slow death, unforeseen, unforgiving.
And we need gold.
Remind
so.
Yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
I know, Uncle Wayne. So Matt, so the next looter will be Daisy. Eventually, one off lethal counted. Come on, Tenchi, you're like
confidence
you're the highest level in here. You should be one shotting these things. I'm very disappointed in you. Maggie will probably have to go defend herself here. swing and a miss. And again, I'm not trying to get the bleeding damage here from Jesse. I'm just simply doing damage. Impact damage. And we can take down the marksman, and that'd be all she wrote for that. I am hoping that our antiquarians come up with a whole lot of gold here. It's been a quiet first quarter so far anyway, but we're just getting to the first quarter. Yeah, a little bit of healing there. I should probably heal. One-off lethal, count it. I feel like you're going to see a lot of one-off lethals in this run. There you go, Jesse getting the stress off there. Good job, Maggie. Hopefully I don't lose track of who's supposed to loot next.
Success. So
the next one is Daisy, I know that, because we just got done getting the bookshelf.
Is it merely a trick of the light?
Now I'll probably rest after the second quarter here. Now the Crimson Court mobs are going to be a little bit more dangerous than the regular mobs in here. So we want to try to take them down as fast as possible. Ah, come on, Tenchi. One-off lethal, count it. I was really hoping we were going to get there with the Blight debuff, but apparently not. Now they're focusing on Daisy, who's at low HP here. Alright, we have to take down the gatekeeper. Otherwise, he's going to call in reinforcements. There we go. Thank you, Jesse. Let's see. I think we should go for... Yeah, there we go. Good job, Daisy. One-off lethal, count it.
Slowly, gently. This is how a life is taken.
All right, first quarter is in the books. Currently, Daisy up by 700 gold. This is what Sinvicta looks like. We would get, only I would get the worst possible like curio spawns in a curio competition between two antiquarians. Like we're gonna get like the absolute minimum amount of curios that spawn on a long duration map. That's called Sinvicta luck right there. I'll probably camp when we get to this room here. More Crimson Court mobs. Take down the gatekeeper. Got the bleed, that's it for him.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Need to heal a little Daisy. It's actually probably better if we go for the Blight instead of the physical attacks against the sycophants. Wow, I'm actually stunned that they're landing these Blights on Tenchi. Remember, it's not like Tenchi's level 1, Tenchi's level 6. Alright, well I guess we just won't land that either. Tenchi don't care.
Masterfully executed.
Got the bleed. Very good. So both of them are just done dizzle. Nice kill by Tenchi. Good kill by Daisy.
A trifling victory.
Alright, here comes Daisy's next loot here. Oh god. It's gonna be 500. I don't know if I'm supposed to count the trinkets. I don't believe so. Hang on. Let me see if I can find gold values for trinkets sold. Let's see, the sell values for an uncommon trinket is 1,500. So Daisy bringing home 2,000 extra gold. Yeah, that's a good start for, that's a good start. By the way, I was off by the 700. I forgot I was 250, not 500 there for Daisy. Now, something I will say is that the challenge did not call for me to save all the gold. It's just the amount that they pick up. I'm going to try to save all the gold, but like if I need to get rid of a trinket or something like that, I can. But I still have to count the valuation. So Daisy takes a huge lead over Maggie right now. If there's a fight in here, all right, yeah. So we'll do one more fight and then we'll camp. Well, maybe we'll keep going. We'll see. And Maggie's is going to be a confession booth. Now, I'm not allowed to use any items on the curios at all. So, no surprise there. And we get another round of the Crimson Court mobs. Things have been working out very well so far for Daisy. Very, very well. And I think that we'll go for... And I think that we'll go for the hit on the gatekeeper. There we go. Good job, Tenchi. It's always a monkey off your back when you don't have to worry about the gatekeepers anymore in a fight. Once the gatekeepers and the sycophants go down, it's like a mini vacation, man. Tenchi's stress is starting to get a little bit higher than I like, so Jesse's gonna take care of that real quick.
The blood quickens.
Thank you, Huckawayne. You okay? I forgot you were here. Yeah, let's finish off the supplicant there. Nice one shot by Tenchi. Good kill.
This expedition at least promises success.
So it's back to Daisy now, and Daisy gets the next curio. So far, I think Maggie's gotten pretty unlucky with the curios that have been spawning. Well, we got another scout. And there's just no fights. And we have to interact with every single curio. Traps, of course, don't count as a curio. Ooh, this might be bad for Daisy.
And now, the darkness holds dominion.
And Daisy now has syphilis. Alright. Alright. Do they have... No, they don't have a snuff box. Let's go ahead and camp here.
A moment of respite. A chance to steel oneself against the coming horrors.
So Maggie has a good chance to catch up now. Let's see. Now we cannot use the scrounge or the provisions. So I think that we'll have strange powders on. We'll cast that on Maggie. Now Maggie can't do anything about anything else here, unfortunately. Turn back time. I mean, we don't really need it. Axing dodge. We'll give that to Maggie as well. And that's just basically just to keep the Antiquarian safe.
In Radiance, may we find victory.
So I'm not going to go up into this fight because we don't need to. So this is Maggie's loot, and let's see what she gets. Maggie.
If only treasure.
Only 550 gold.
Otherworldly corruption.
So that brings it to 1,100. And she still trails Daisy by a whole lot. But what I will say is that it did swing. It swung around in Daisy's favor very easily by just finding one trinket. And it's not like Maggie's not going to have the ability to do so as well. Just it's about luck of the draw. But right now, Daisy's currently crushing it. Now, of course, I'm going to be a little bit biased in the sense that like I'm going to be rooting for my dog. My literal dog. Yeah, it's going to be another 750 gold for Daisy, who continues to just destroy Maggie right now. She goes up to 4,000 gold. And again, we're not counting. There's no numerical value for the heirlooms, obviously. So the next one looted here will be for Maggie. All right, Maggie, this is a good chance for you to catch up. And she found a map. Oh, Maggie. Is there going to be a secret door? The secret door could change everything, though. Okay, there's still a lot of curios that are left on this map, so there's still time for Maggie to catch up. I'm honestly surprised that we did not find the secret door with that map. Here comes Daisy now. And oh my god. Okay, Daisy. Food sells for 5 gold each. That's 10. That's 1,510 gold. So Daisy takes a huge lead now. And again, I still count the gold even if we don't take the, even if we don't take it to our possession. Maggie in a lot of trouble now, trailing by 4,410 gold. Let's see here. Yeah, we'll just get the harvest. Again, I don't know who's rooting for Rue. I don't know who's rooting for who, but this is kind of, I'm starting to get into this challenge. Every curio I see now, I'm like, whoa, who's going to loot next? I kind of like it. Maggie going to try to get the Blight, or at least get the debuff, or nothing. That's fine too, I guess. But so far, it's been all Daisy, and the difference maker being a couple of nasty non-looting curios that Maggie has had to interact with. Now again, I was hit by Jesse. I don't know if Giuseppe wanted me to do just curios that provide money or all curios. They put all curios, so that's how I'm interpreting that. Unfortunately for Maggie, none of this counts.
So too will resistance.
We don't need deeds. We're just here for gold. We actually do need gold. Quite badly, actually. So this is the perfect time for this this challenge. So here we go, Maggie. Again, another good opportunity here. If it's a curio that provides gold, and it is, what we got? Maggie. Another torch, one torch, I forget how much torch to sell for. I think torch to sell for 15. Is it 15 or 5? Well, I guess I could look real quick. 5, yeah, so it's 530 gold for Maggie, which is not nearly enough of what she needs right now. And there's a chest in this next room, which is gonna be Daisy's loot. I think that we should take down the courtiers and then we should do a little bit of a stress reset here. I guess the two rabble. Although, I will say that one off lethal count it. I will say that unlike other parties that we usually have here, the rabble actually do pose a little bit of a risk to the antiquarians. Let's go for a protect me. I just want to get Tenchi's stress down just a little bit. Not a whole lot, but just a little bit. I'm going to take one round or two here just to slightly delay. You see how like the rabble actually deal pretty dangerous damage to the antiquarians that have basically no HP. Maggie swaps the guard. Perfect time, too. Wow, they actually hit Jesse. Jesse's got... Oops. Jesse's got a lot of dodge right now. I'm surprised they were able to hit him. So Daisy gonna throw on the Protect Me on Maggie, who then throws the Protect Me on Jesse. I like this dueling antiquarian guard. I'll have Jesse do a one stress relief on himself, and then we're good to go. Nice heal by Tenchi. Sedated.
Be gone, fiend.
So this is Maggie, or this is Daisy's chance to take a huge lead over Maggie. There we go.
Foolish horrors. Brought low and driven into the mud.
All right. Again, we're not allowed to use curios to interact with anything. So it's gonna be a mimic, and this is actually dangerous now.
A time to perform beyond one's limits.
This is actually dangerous because the mimic does deal a lot of damage. We need to get Jesse into the third position here. If we can get the Blight rolling on the Mimic, that would be also nice. Still not able to get it, but we did get the debuff, that's good. The debuff will lower the Blight resistance of the target. We really need Jesse to be in third position so we can start landing some bleeds here. I'm gonna move Tenchi back one. And we're going to continue to try to lower the debuff. There we go. We were able to get the Blight with Maggie. Toothy Maw, Maggie. That's for 11. There we go. More Blight. And you go for Maggie again. Hey, Jesse, you got to get in the third position here. Nice crit by Daisy. The boss is not active. Then you go for Tenchi this time. There we go. Tenchi gets a full heal on Maggie. Gonna spew on Daisy. Here we go. Finally, Jesse's able to do something. Apparently the riposte crit for 0? Question mark? We didn't get the Blight. I guess the debuff did wear off. Another 11 damage on Maggie. Another resist, but we did get the debuff that time. And they're still going after Maggie. We gotta kill this mimic quick here. 3 damage by Daisy. They're still going after Maggie. And Maggie's stunned, so I can't use Defend Me here. They're using Adhesive on Maggie, which doesn't deal any damage. We should just go for the impact. All we gotta do is... Oh no, it's already dead. Yeah, we don't even have to hit him here. Alright, so it got a little scary, but there you go. And unfortunately, we're not counting that gold here for Daisy. Come to think of it, I don't know why I bought provisions, because I'm not allowed to interact with any of the curios. So now we go into a situation where Maggie actually has a chance to catch up here, because that was Daisy's loot and Maggie trails by a whole lot. It's a sarcophagus. Sarcophagus can contain gold. Nice crit by Tenchi
with impunity.
know that we need to do stress relief here, but I want to get another one of the mobs down before we start worrying about that. Yeah, go after Jesse. Jesse can take it. Just leave the antiquarians alone. There we go. Blighting them up. The next physical attack against the soul or against the marksman should do it. Daisy gets moved, but not stunned. All right.
A momentary abatement.
Two damage coming in from Maggie. They go five damage, man. Look, we're not running the damage antiquarian builds here as well. So don't misconstrue this damage. More like, oh yeah, real good damage, Sinvicta. Look, they do deal good damage, alright? Just not in this run because it's not the whole point of the run. This isn't a who can do the most damage in an antiquarian run. This is a who brings home the most bacon. I didn't have to do a dark run here, but I figured why not maximize profits because we do need the profits. So unfortunately, Jesse got moved. So we cannot get any stress healing here. Go for a stun, how about that? Yeah, there we go. This buys Jesse a round of stress healing for probably Maggie. There we go.
Momentary abatement.
And again, I'm just gonna bypass the 25% protection here and just go straight up for blight damage. I mean, he's got zero blight resist. There's literally no way that he can resist it.
Inspiration.
Thank you, Uncle
Wayne. Improvement.
Nice top off heal here from Tenchi. All right, Maggie, this is your chance. This is Maggie's chance to get a lot of gold here. She needs to make up a lot. Maggie, hidden treasures. What is it? Big time get for Maggie. 1,550 gold. That's what I'm talking about, Maggie. There you go. So Maggie goes to 2,180 gold. Well done, Maggie. Yeah, we're gonna have to get rid of the trinket. That's okay. So Maggie finally making up a little bit of ground here against Daisy. But she needs a lot more than that.
Terrors may indeed stalk these shadows, but yonder, a glint of gold.
I actually meant to type a 3 there, not a 2. Sorry about that. You haven't seen it yet because I forgot to save the... So for those of you who don't know... Oh, this is going to be a book loot for Daisy. So she's going to get no gold from this either. Oh, maybe she will. Daisy did. 500 gold. Look at that.
To be spent.
Good job. I keep forgetting that you can get gold from that. So for those of you who don't know how I'm tallying these numbers here... I have a remote notepad that allows me to basically do this, and it won't update on OBS until I save. So Maggie gets a loot, well, another big loot measure. Here for Maggie. Sick this time.
To the brave,
yeah, 1,100 gold.
Alike.
So Maggie, starting to come back here. It's on to Daisy again. We did not go down here. It's gonna be a bookshelf, and I'm pretty sure you can't get gold out of a bookshelf. Yeah, I didn't think so. Can't be that lucky. So now it goes back to Maggie. Maggie here. Oh, but it's a knight. It's a suit of armor. You can't get gold out of that. I know that for a fact. Big hit by Jesse. Jesse was really excited after that one. Big hit by Tenchi!
Compassion is a rarity in the fevered pitch of battle.
There we go. So this one will go back to Maggie. There we go.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
And there are, by my count, there are still at least 5 curios that they can do. I'm wondering if we should camp now. We probably should. Although I guess we don't need to, but we do need to get rid of some inventory space soon here. I'll probably camp after this room. Oh, it's a bookshelf for Maggie. And another negative quirk for Maggie. Tuckered out. Wow, we're gonna have to take care of that when we get back to town. So now the chest goes over to Daisy. This is going to be a chest. Could also be a mimic. I'm hoping it's not. Nice hit by Jesse. Actually hit Jesse. Not only did I hit him, they crit him. Alright, Tenchi, you're not supposed to be missing, like, anything. Another crit by Jesse. Actually, now that I think about it, that one should have been Daisy, because Maggie got the armor. So this one will be Maggie. Yeah, when armor, bookshelf, it went armor, Maggie, bookshelf, Daisy, which is the one that Maggie just got done doing. So this one will be Maggie. Look, I knew I was gonna lose track of this one. All right, this is gonna keep on critting up a storm here. Tenchi, out of all the people here, you should be the last one who is missing stuff. So we're gonna delay a little bit here just to get the stress down. Just a little bit. And then go for Daisy here. It's also not helping that, like, the antiquarians keep shuffling around in the group as well. Give this brawler the slowest death of his life here. There we go. So this one, since the bookshelf was supposed to be Daisy, this one is actually Maggie's loot here. So Maggie has a good chance to catch up. She needs to catch up as well. It's gonna be a trap. There's no gold for that. Well, now I don't feel so bad about doing the bookshelf out of order.
Huddled together, furtive and vulnerable.
So rats, swing and a whiff for Maggie. Let's get the bleeding off of the antiquarians here. There we go. Sure. Curious incantation. Sure.
The match is struck.
So now the next loot will go back to Daisy with only 4 loots left. Daisy. Nothing. Maggie trailing by 1,730 gold. which is very easily done. Oh, but she gets another bookshelf. But hey, she got a positive quirk. Yeah, there you go. There's 2 for 1. I don't feel so bad about mislooting the bookshelf now, but with only 2 curios left to go, potentially anyway, it's gonna come down to Maggie being the final loot.
Such a terrible assault cannot be left unanswered.
Yeah. Alright. I'm just hoping to land the debuff so we can lower the blight resistance of these things. Alright, Jesse. Go ahead and get the bleeds out. 6 damage there on the gatekeeper from Daisy. I'll take that. Still really surprised they're able to easily land all this blight damage on my level 6 vessel here. So Maggie will be the last person to be able to loot here. And it's got to be a doozy in order for her to take the win. I mean, 1,700 gold is, that's a lot of gold. However, just that's basically just one large antique and one minor antique, and that brings her right back. Nice hit by Daisy. Jesse's got to get his stress under control. I'm pretty sure that they're both dead from the bleed anyway. So here we go, this one's gonna be Daisy's loot. And it is a torch. Oh man, 1255. Did we say that was 5 gold for the torches? Yeah. So 1255 gold out of that one for Daisy. So here we go. The last one. Maggie has to hope that it's a chest and has to hope that it's something big. The only thing that she wouldn't be able to loot would be and get gold from would be a suit of armor. I think that's it. Just a suit of armor. So as long as there's something other than a suit of armor that I can think of anyway, Maggie has a chance to get gold from this. But Maggie needs to have, she needs to find something huge. And there's nothing in here! So that's it. That's all she wrote. Daisy. Taking the first one down. I'll devise a better way next time to keep track of who's looting what. I'll probably put a little asterisk or something next to the number to help me keep track of it. I think I only got off that one time there. So Daisy's going to be able to take that. Round one goes to Team Daisy. Good job, Daisy. It's hard not to root for a little Shih Tzu puppy. But I was also rooting for Maggie. I was really hoping there was going to be a chest in here. And that way we could get like a little bit of suspense going. But no, that was it. So, but the dual antiquarian run was a lot of fun. Definitely a little bit slower paced than the, oh, you know what? Actually, hang on a second. There's still a hallway that we haven't gone to. Now that I'm looking at the map, there's still one hallway that's not been scouted yet, so it's not over. I didn't realize that we didn't actually go down this hallway here. So it's not over yet. Technically, it's not over.
As life ebbs, terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves.
So those of you on Team Maggie, hang on a second. Plot twist, there is a chance that there might be something lootable down there. It's not over yet. I apologize. I forgot that we hadn't gone down there. And actually, now that I look at it, there's also another undiscovered slot here. Actually, no, that is discovered because we scouted that room. We didn't actually go into that room, but we scouted it. So, yeah, so there's nothing down this hallway. However, we did not scout this hallway at all. So, but now that, but also, it is going to be Daisy's next loot. So the only hope that Maggie has is that there is A, two curios down here, and B, the curio that she's allowed to loot has gold in it. It's still a long shot. I'm not saying that Maggie is, you know, she's got a huge chance to win here, but it is still a chance. But it's kind of a miracle long shot at this point. Because since Maggie was the one who... No, I take that back. Because there was nothing in that room for Maggie to loot. So it is going to be Maggie's loot. Oh my god, and we found the secret door! Hang on a second. Because the secret door just got discovered, we can go there first. So Maggie will get first crack at the secret door. What a huge turn here. So Maggie will be able to go loot inside of the secret door. What is she gonna get? We don't have a key, and if we did, we're not allowed to use it anyway. Maggie. No, she didn't get a puzzling trapezohedron. Oh man, is that gonna be enough? It's 1250, 1750 gold for Maggie. And I don't think that's going to be enough. That's 6,030 gold by my count. Let me make sure I got that total right here. It's 1,750 gold. That wasn't enough. Was that the right number? Now I'm starting to think about it. Did I put 1,700 or 1,250? At this point, I've lost track. Well, we got another hunger event, but we still have this hallway to go down. At this point, I'm just. The next time there's math involved, I'm just gonna get the calculator. That's like actually embarrassing. Not being able to do basic math. Well, unfortunately, we don't get. Sets in, turning the body against itself. Daisy still has the next go on the loot. We don't know what's down here. So Maggie's only hope is if there's two lootable curios in here and hers actually does give gold. And there's nothing here. All right, so there you go. So it is going to be little Daisy taking it home. But what an exciting conclusion that was there. Look at that, 47,000 gold. On top of the 750 gold. In total, 5,400 gold. 5,425 gold. Good lord. Hey, we needed gold big time, but it is going to be Daisy taking that one as we go into the weekend. So thank you very much for the viewer challenge, Giuseppe. Also, everyone who also voted on that one. I do appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed that one as well. Next time I'll get an indicator on who loots next and whatever, because that is a little bit difficult to keep track of, especially when people are like shuffling around and stuff and they change positions. So thank you for watching. Hope you had a great start to your weekend. Thank you for supporting Darkest Dungeon Season 4 here on the channel. And of course, if you're a new subscriber, make sure you hit the notification bell so you get notified when my newest videos do go live. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody! That's not the right one. OBS!